she got a hold on me. She's the warmth of the summer, the color of the spring. She's the strongest wind, the calmest breeze. That woman, she got a hold on. Girl, she's like the finest wine. She'll give you a taste if you give her time. She's a complex heart and I don't mind. That girl, she's like the finest wine. That girl, she's like the finest wine. Now drink until my heart is full. Honey, drink me and I drink you. You're the kind of love I'm running to. Gotta hold on me, gotta hold on you. Gotta hold on me, yes you got a hold on me. She's a mighty river mountain.
Please be seated. Good afternoon and welcome as we come together to celebrate the happy occasion, the wedding of Mandy and Rhys. On behalf of the bride and groom, thank you for being here, whether from great distance or just down the street. Rhys and Mandy are thrilled that this day has arrived and so grateful that you've taken the time to attend. Weddings are one of those rare occasions in life where you find yourself surrounded by a sea of the people who mean the most. And that fact is certainly not lost on these two. With that in mind, I know they're eager for me to get things moving as I'm the one thing standing between them and an evening of celebration with all of you. And of course, the open bar. This afternoon, we're gathered at Bracknell Lodge. Take a look around. You'll be hard-pressed to find a more stunning, uniquely Australian and fitting venue to exchange vows. Being out in nature has a way of simultaneously awing us and grounding us, reminding us of the important things in life. The same can be said for marriage. It keeps alive our sense of wonder, anchoring us and focusing us on which really matters. And so as the sun prepares to set on this day, we prepare to give to the newly formed marriage of the Hangers. For those of you I have not yet had the opportunity to meet, I am Sam Jones and I'm duly authorised by law to solemnise marriages according to law and to officiate your marriage today. In addition to having the pleasure to serve as today's celebrant, I'm also Amanda's dearest friend and Rhys's unofficial brother from another mother. Thanks, Pam. It's a journey of love I've been fortunate to be a part of, from your first meeting on that cold winter's night all the way up to where you stand today to get married. I hope you both know how much it means to me that you've asked me to share this day by serving as your celebrant. I feel privileged that I've been tasked with the responsibility of overseeing the joining of two people who are beloved by so many of us. And there is many of us. The bridal party, immediate and extended family, friends and colleagues. Well, I've lost my spot. Each one of you has helped shape them into the upstanding individuals as well as what has become an inviolable couple. Their story is interwoven with your own. Their happiness is possible because of the influence of each and every person here. In addition to the significant influences who came before us, who we know are looking down from above, beaming with smiles, all of whom we remember today in spirit. Rhys and Mandy, I hope you can both feel the love and support radiating from those of us here to witness your day. This is a moment you've eagerly anticipated and will undoubtedly remember forever. At this time, I encourage you to turn and face those gathered here today. Take a few seconds. Bask in their smiles. Take a mental snapshot of the scene before you. Store it away for those inevitable tough days, knowing that you are loved by so many. Please join me in giving these two a hearty round of applause. Father Peter has played a pivotal role in the Finlay family, and we invite him to come forward and share some words.
Oh, well, good afternoon, everybody, Peter, and it's delightful to be here on this occasion with Rhys and Mandy, of course. And my task is just to share a little blessing, and thank you, Sam, for the opportunity to do this. So, gentle God, source of all life, we ask that you bless Mandy and Rhys, who this day have committed themselves to be companions for life, with hearts on fire, with love for one another. Mandy and Rhys, may you journey together with joy and delight, with compassion and tenderness. And may you be open to one another, willing to listen and willing to forgive. May you be open to the presence of God in your life, in times of happiness and of sadness. May you respect the goodness of the lives of those around you who love you both dearly. And may you find room in your life for those who are vulnerable, those who are in need, whom you may meet. May you continue to be wonderful people in whom God delights, and we thank you for the blessing you are for all of us. Thank you.
Thank you. I'm back. Before we unite these lovebirds in marriage and send them off into their future, let's spend a few minutes reminiscing about their story and the chain of events that has led us to be here today. The two first met back in 2018 at a friend's housewarming party. It was a cold night, made more tolerable by a roaring bonfire in the backyard. Mandy and Rhys were seated at opposite sides of the fire, sneaking shrouded looks through the smoke, until eventually striking up the nerve to talk to each other. But once they did, it kicked off beautifully, and they found themselves engaged in conversation for the remainder of the night. After about 3 weeks, they went on their first date, agreeing to meet at a pub. Classic Rhys. I should note, this spot was a 2.5 hour drive for Mandy, so suffice to say she must have seen something in Rhys. Or perhaps better said, in the great words of Barry Manilow, well, you came and you gave without taking. The milestones started to come quickly, exchanging our love yous, memorable camping holidays, buying a house together, their unique engagement, and surviving a backyard Christmas renovation, much like the conditions today. But let's talk engagement. Rhys had planned a camping trip to Double Island Point for the two of them, along with me and my wife Amber. We drove up the beach, ultimately stopping at the lighthouse walk. About halfway up the trail, the heat started to get overwhelming, and Amber and Mandy were insisting we cut the hike short. But Rhys and I, knowing they were grander planned ahead, convinced them to keep going. Finally, with the steep walk completed, we were ready for the big moment. That is until we realised there was a crowd of people standing in the exact spot where we intended to deploy the drone. It felt like forever, and the girls were wondering why we were just standing around. But eventually they moved on and cleared the way for the perfect proposal. And with that, here we are this afternoon. So Mandy and Rhys, take a deep breath. You've made it. In the lead up to your nuptials, it's easy to become convinced that a wedding day is about achieving some kind of coordinated perfection. And while today has certainly come together perfectly, I invite you to be both present in this moment now, surrounded by those who bring meaning to your life and to whom you bring meaning in return. I feel confident speaking for everyone here today when I say we couldn't be happier for the both of you. Prior to the ceremony, I asked each of you what you love about each other, and your responses tell me you have many happy years ahead. Mandy, you told me how you love how caring and supportive Rhys is, and despite having to watch him eat tuna, or listening to him snore after a big night of drinking, which is probably tonight, you appreciate how he's a good listener and adore he's willing to give anything a go. And Rhys, you told me that Mandy is caring and kind, willing to help anyone. And while she might be a bit indecisive at times, any annoyance is quickly forgotten when her beautiful smile lights up the room. Continue to cherish these qualities in marriage and seek to discover others that draw you even closer together. I find it insightful that you seem most comfortable and most in a state of happiness in the simplest of times. Camping, hiking, boating, or hosting a casual dinner with friends. The way I see it, that right there is love. Finding happiness, joy, your purpose on this planet with the person you're meant to be with in the moments that others would overlook. Continue to recognize the profound power and the intimate moments together. Amidst the milestones and photo-worthy events coupled with memories you'll continue to make together. It is your uninterrupted time together, away from the eyes of others, that will truly define your marriage, and that you will knowingly smile upon someday, hands intertwined with a life, and deeply satisfied with a life well lived. I find it most appropriate that your wedding vehicles today are the Toyota Troop Carrier and the Hilux. For those of you who don't know, on the night they first met, Rhys had borrowed the Troop Carrier, and since then, all their adventures have been within the confines of the Hilux, despite Mandy's refusal to drive. As you've chosen to do today, may you always remember the spark from your first meeting, and may you continue to celebrate many adventures ahead. Mandy and Rhys, your marriage will not always be easy, but you've been gifted with each other to weather any headwinds or storms that lie ahead. May your love, your friendship, deepen with each passing year. And may this marriage be blessed with joy, fulfillment, health, family, and realized dreams. You both deserve nothing less. Before you are joined in marriage, in my presence, and in the presence of these witnesses, I am to remind you of the solemn and binding nature of the relationship into which you are now about to enter. Marriage, according to law in Australia, is the union of two people to the exclusion of all others, voluntarily entered into for life. This is your last chance, Mandy.
I'm in.
You're in. And now we turn to your wedding vows. Do we have the vows? We've got half the vows.
One drop.
There was a bit of a kerfuffle. Who have we got? Stand by. I came prepared. Mandy, we'll start with you.
Okay. Rhys, you are my everything. You mean the absolute world to me, and I can't imagine my life without you in it. Ever since I met you, I've been so happy, and I can honestly say that you make me smile every day. Sorry. And that every memory we have together is something that I will treasure forever. The past couple of years have been amazing as we've grown together and experienced life's ups and downs, supporting each other through anything that life threw at us. Thank you for always being there for me. You've been the person that I've been able to rely on. I feel that we bring the best out in each other, and I'm grateful for all the lessons that you've taught me to become stronger and live life to the fullest. I love you so much. I love your nature and who you are as a person, as you've always shown me great support, love, and respect. Rhys, you are truly one of a kind, and I feel so lucky to have you in my life. Today, I commit my love to you. I vow to stand by your side. I vow to spend every day showing you the love and happiness that you deserve. Rhys, I fell in love with you. And I haven't looked back since meeting you. I can't wait for our future together. Oh, sorry.
That was beautiful.
And now, Rhys. Yours looks a little bit shorter.
Hard to back that one up. Mandy, you are the earth to my ocean. You are the flint to my fire. You make me smile every day. You make me glow with happiness. I admire the way you put the needs of others before the needs of your own. You're always willing to do the hard yards to get the job done. I promise to love and support you in all your aspirations. I promise to be there in good times and hard times. Most of all, I love you.
Thanks, Pam. With words of your own, you've breathed life into this new marriage. And with these family and friends surrounding to bear witness, we amplify your vows with a declaration of intent to verbally and formally solidify by law what you've just solidified by spirit. Rhys, please repeat after me. I call upon the persons here present to witness.
I call upon the persons here present to witness.
That I, Rhys Hanger, take you, Amanda Finlay.
That I, Rhys Hanger, take you, Amanda Finlay.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
I promise to love you, to care for you, and respect you all my life.
I promise to love you and to care for you all my life.
Mandy, please repeat after me. I call upon the persons here present to witness.
I call upon the persons here present to witness.
That I, Amanda Finlay.
That I, Amanda Finlay.
Take you, Rhys Hanger, to be my lawful wedded husband.
To take you, Rhys Hanger, to be my lawful wedded husband.
I promise to love you, to care you, to care for you, and respect you for all my life.
I promise to love you, care for you, and respect you for all of your life.
That was my fault. And now the wedding rings. For centuries, the circle has been a symbol of completeness, with no beginning and no end. These rings symbolize eternity and your perpetual love. They're an outward and visible sign of the inward and invisible bond that unites you both. Let them serve as an omnipresent reminder of the larger cause to which you commit to today. As often as you look at them, remember always that you love someone special and someone special loves you. Mandy, as you place Rhys's ring on his finger, please repeat after me. Rhys, I give you this ring as a daily reminder of my love and commitment to you.
Rhys, I give you this ring as a daily reminder of my love and commitment to you.
Put it on. Yeah. Rhys, as you place the ring on Mandy's finger, please repeat after me. Mandy, I give you this ring as a daily reminder of my love and commitment to you.
Mandy, I give you this ring as my love and commitment to you.
And just face this way for the camera. Perfect. Rhys and Mandy, before each of you is a container of sand. It's just to the right. Which represents you and all that you've ever been, all that you are, and all that you ever will be. Today you are combining all of you and your uniqueness into the final vessel. Just as these grains of sand can no longer be separated into individual containers, so shall your lives forever be intertwined. I now invite you to pour your sand into the final vessel. You can see two different layers of sand. This sand represents marriage of the bride and groom, the first being coastal beach sand, Rhys's origin, and the second, red sand, a symbol of Mandy's connection to the land. Rhys and Mandy, with vows exchanged, rings affixed, and sand mixed to symbolize your two lives merging to one, you are now prepared to enter into the covenant of marriage. From this moment, you walk together on a joint path and participate in a shared adventure. Remember, today is not the fulfillment of your marriage, but rather just the foundation. And that all takes place, and all that takes place from this moment forward, all that makes life worth living, birth, deaths, promotions, will occur in the bounds of this union. And so it is with great enthusiasm for your future, I now pronounce you husband and wife.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my distinct honor to introduce you to the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Mandy. Please, Mandy, see you married to us.
I was a wide-eyed soul, searching high and low, when I found you on that day. Then the answer was clear, winds drift others away, but we will always be near. I'm gonna love you forever.